Welcome to CBS Sports HQ. I'm Jenny Del. He is Chris Hassel, and we got some breaking news coming in to HQ right now. Another coach out in the NBA.
Yeah, now four openings as the Pacers reportedly fire their head coach, Nate Bjorkgren, after just one season at the helm there in Indiana. Had some issues with players. There were some fights on the bench between players and assistant coaches. Locker room just was not good, and the Pacers did not make it into the playoffs. Nate Bjorkgren was part of the Nick Nurse coaching tree and assistant with the Toronto Raptors when they won the NBA title a couple of seasons ago, but in one season finished below 500, 34-38. And again, locker room issues was really the key to this. Let's bring in former NBA Coach of the Year, Avery Johnson. Avery, this was one and done. I mean, it rarely happens for a coach in the NBA. We've seen it before, but for a first-time head coach to only be given 1 year, what are your thoughts on this?
Well, it's typical new NBA. It's all about microwavable success. It's not about letting it simmer and cook in the oven and give a coach time to, even if his culture is not the way it should be, not giving the coach a chance to repair it. But this is an organization that wasn't on life support. This is the same organization that fired Nate McMillan, who's now, by the way, tied in a 1-1 series with the Philadelphia 76ers coaching the Atlanta Hawks, who could have very well been the NBA in the running for NBA Coach of the Year had he been coaching all year. So you just have to look at, you know, the decision-making in terms of hiring the coach, giving up on the coach after 1 year, and then why in the world was Nick McMillan let go? Considering the impeccable job that he did, sure, he ran into some really tough teams in his first round of the playoffs when he was coaching the Pacers, like the Cleveland Cavaliers with LeBron James. But again, this is not a shock. It's basically, you know, NBA as usual in this new microwavable society.
Yeah, this seemed like, you mentioned writing on the wall, this seemed like it was going to happen as of about a month ago, regardless of what Indiana did in the play-in tournament. How much of this was on the court versus off the court, in your opinion?
I think it was more off the court, because when you don't really have that type of discipline and your culture is fragmented, it's going to carry over on the court. So if you're seeing players fighting with coaches and, you know, getting the verbal confrontation, physical confrontations, you know, guys supposedly late for practices and airplanes, departures, and it's just infested the culture and the environment, and it carries over to a lack of consistency and production on the court. So whatever happens behind the curtains, if it's not solid and solidified and stable, then you're going to see that type of dissension and inconsistency in any sport or business. And that's why the leadership must be solid. And the leadership cannot be lame duck, because if the leadership is lame duck, then this is the type of results you'll see happen. Coach will be let go after 1 year.
Let go of Nate McMillan, who had a lot of experience, and that turns out to be a mistake. Doing a great job with the Atlanta Hawks in the postseason. They tried it with a first-year head coach and a younger coach in Nate Bjorkgren. Do you think they've learned a lesson here and that they might want to go back to a more experienced head coach with their coaching search?
Yeah, I would be surprised if they go down this same path. I could see them potentially hiring a former head coach or a coach that have had, you know, maybe one or two head coaching stints in the NBA, a little bit more experience, maybe somebody that comes in the door with a little bit more cachet and experience and have had some level of success. You know, Greg Popovich is not walking through that door. So he's not available. So I think you can look for some of the usual suspects to be mentioned with this type of a job, whether it's Jason Kidd or Mark Jackson. You know, we're starting to hear Mike D'Antoni. I think Mike D'Antoni was involved with this job before he took the Nets assistant coaching job. So you'll hear some of the usual names as it relates to this job opening.
When you compare the opening here that the Pacers have to the Blazers, the Celtics, the Magic, where do the Pacers stack up in the four openings right now?
Well, I don't think they're at the top of that list because when you're talking about Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown, you know, those guys with the Celtics, obvious Damian Lillard with Portland, I don't think this roster measures up quite side by side with those rosters. I think this job is pretty much on par with the Orlando Magic situation. A lot of young players that need to be developed. Obviously, Caris LeVert, Sabonis, they're two really good building blocks, but they have a lot of work to do with this Pacers roster, especially to keep up with teams like the 76ers, Brooklyn Nets, the Miami Heat. You know, they will be back. Milwaukee, even though they're struggling in this series, have a significantly better roster than the Pacers. So they have a lot of work to do. This is not necessarily a free agent destination, so they'll have to build it through the draft. And, you know, maybe trying to work with some of the guys that get bought out with their contracts during the year, similar to what the Clippers did with Cousins, who had a couple of points last night in his first game in a long time. So they have a lot of work to do with this roster.
That's Avery Johnson on the Pacers reportedly firing Nate Bjorkman after just one season at the helm. Sounds like more off the court issues than on the court, though they did not make the eight-team playoff in the Eastern Conference, losing out in the play-in tournament. Avery, thank you so much. We do have just one game tonight in the NBA, and then two tomorrow. Tonight's game doesn't start till 9:30. The Suns and Nuggets, Phoenix up 1-0 in that series. The Bucks are going to look for some home cooking. They got blown out. They've looked overmatched in both games of their series against the Nets. Maybe they can get back in the series. They are a three-point favorite at home tomorrow night, 7:30 against the Nets. And the Clippers and Jazz after last night's good game Thursday at 10. The Jazz leading that series one game to none.
Do you want a sports network that delivers everything that matters about the game? The highlights, the picks, the instant analysis. No yelling, no fake debates, no politics. Hit the subscribe button and never miss a moment.